Hi, this is Robert Carlyle, and I play Colquhoun and Ives. This scene was actually filmed on my birthday. This is the 14th of April, 1998. It's not that often you remember as an actor a specific date, but that was me celebrating my birthday lying there in the snow and the ice in Slovakia.
See if you can rouse Knox.
Let's get these rags off.
Let's see if we can get this blood moving. Chocolate, more water.
What I was trying to go for here in this scene was to try and give a kind of almost Jesus-like image. Which is apparent, I think, once you see it, but it's maybe too quick that shot to register.
He's warm.
Frostbite didn't seem to do.
Excuse me. I'm sorry. My name's Colquhoun.
This was the first scene that I shot in the film.
F.W. Colquhoun.
Which was, it's nice because it's the introduction of the character, but it's also, it was a bit scary because there's about 6 pages of dialogue to follow. So there's an awful lot of pressure on just to kickstart the film.
How long were you out there?
3 months.
Without food?
This is the obligatory Robert Carlyle arse shot.
Good lord. Good lord.
God knows why anybody would pay good money to see that, really.
It's 30 pounds heavier.
I'm sorry, but you...
Chase him up this hill here. I actually caught him at one point. This is a retractable knife in my hand. I remember stabbing him in the ass with a retractable knife. It was very funny. So they couldn't actually use the shot because it looked too comical.
You can't help him! He's dead, soldier! Now let's move! Boy!
I always thought it was a shame that Toffler went so soon in the film because he was a lovely presence. And he ended up... a snack. The location for this sequence here was one of the most beautiful I've ever seen. The drop from the cliff that I'm standing off there was probably about 150 feet straight down. It's stunning, part of a national park in Slovakia.
Right. I'm gonna go back.
Find him.
This next piece from myself, this is a kind of an homage to Halloween and Friday the 13th and all these kind of movies, and the bad guy just won't stay down, so there's a kind of mocking. Taking the piss, really. We shot this sequence about 3 times, because his son problems with the light. Because it moved around very quickly over these mountains here. So we went back to this location 3 times to shoot this. I love that. These were Czechoslovakian stuntmen. I don't care what Guy Pearce says, these were definitely Czechoslovakian stuntmen. And they are the best in the world, without a doubt. I know that Steven Spielberg uses the Czech guys all the time. And most of these unfortunates that drowned jumping off the Titanic were Czech stuntmen also. It's always a lot easier playing Colonel Ives even from a makeup point of view, because obviously with Calhoun there was extensions in the hair and stuck on beard. The only piece of makeup on me at this point is a tiny little piece at the bottom of my chin. So I'm very proud of that moustache actually.
My last physical examination was not that long ago. Surely Major Knox has no desire to hear me cough.
Bill Brostrup at the back there, he definitely gets the medal for being the most patient actor in the world. He was out in Slovakia for as long as we were, for very few filming days, so he gets the prize.
The other shoulder, please, Colonel.
He wipes the blood from Boyd's face and has a mini orgasm over it, basically. Very tender moment here between Ives and Boyd in the middle of all of this. The kind of knowledge about each other, I think, kind of, they know what each other are about. We were struggling for a line here, and this was an improvised. I actually made myself laugh saying this. So it wasn't scripted at all, but it just needed something just to kind of let the audience laugh.
If you die first, I am definitely gonna eat you. The question is, if I die, what are you gonna do? Bon appetit.
One of the hardest decisions to make as an actor is whether you die with your eyes open or closed. A lot easier to die with your eyes closed, but if you can manage to not blink, it can be effective. Go on, kiss him. It was quite tough in the Tartarus for a few months making this movie, but this sequence here, lying there in that bear trap, covered in blood, even though we look sweaty, that's glycerine. It's freezing cold, covered in gallons of sticky blood. And that's what I call suffering, man. Tony's original idea was to try and take the camera right out of the barn, so it went up into the sky at the end, but we couldn't quite manage that, so, but it's still a nice image.